Isometric projection of solids. Before entering into the syllabus of class 12, let us recall some basic concepts of isometric projection which we have already covered in class 11th. For the same, let me take an example of cube. As you can see, it's a cube. It's a cube of size a by a by a. Now, if we wish to project this solid orthographically, we need to observe this solid from the front first, from the top and from the side. Observing from the front first, front view of this cube from the front, view from the front, front view of this cube will be a square of size a by a. Similarly, if we observe the same solid from the top, top view of the solid will be a square of size a by a. Similarly, the side view, last view, preferably from the right side, or you can observe it from the left side. So the side view of this cube again will be a square of size a by a. So in total, all three views, front view, top view and side view of this cube are same. All are squares of size a by a, a by a, a by a. So in total, all these three views, front view, top view and side view, are square by shape and of size a by a. Now trying to change the scheme of projection, again taking the same cube. Now if I rotate this cube like this, gradually, I'm increasing this angle of the face from the vertical plane, gradually shear of the front view will reduce gradually and shear of the side view will increase gradually. At a certain angle, shear of front view and shear of side view both becomes same, equal. Now fixing this angle, again providing some angle from the horizontal plane for the solid, providing some angle from the horizontal plane and providing that angle gradually, increasing the value of that angle. Again, after certain angle, the shear of front view, side view and top view becomes same, equal. Fixing this position, this is the position in which shear of front view, shear of side view and shear of the top view all becomes same, equal. This position is known as isometric position. And the front view of this cube in this position is known as isometric projection. So isometric projection is a pictorial projection in which all three views, front view, top view and side view of any object exists in a single drawing with equal share. And for providing that equal share, we divide our entire space, entire working space, in three equal parts by drawing three lines at an angle 120 apart. So this is first part, first reason for front view, second part, second reason for side view, and third part, third reason for the top view. Now comparing these two schemes, orthographic projection and isometric projection. Now here is the isometric projection of a cube which we are talking. So this is isometric projection of a cube and this one is orthographic projection of the same cube. Now for us, it is very simple, very easy to understand the meaning of all these squares because we know the basic concepts of orthographic projection. But for a normal person, it is very difficult to understand the meaning. For them, this type of projection, pictorial projection, is very very simple to understand. Generally, it is in our habit to start with a horizontal line. Now, if we draw a horizontal line like this, and we know that angle between two isometric axes is 120, so 180 minus 120 will be 60, and maintaining symmetricity will divide 60 by 2, will get 30-30. And that is why we start with these two axes from straight line, first axis at an angle of 30, second axis at an angle of 30 and third axis perpendicular to this line. In actual, isometric axes are 120 apart. So now let me explain isometric lines, isometric planes, non-isometric lines and isometric axes for you. These three axes are known as isometric axis. In these planes, under these axes, we have certain planes, first plane, second plane, third plane. In total, we have total six planes. Here, these three planes are known as isometric planes. and any plane parallel to these reference planes are known as isometric planes. Similarly, these are isometric axes, and any line along this solid or along any of the plane which is also parallel to any of the isometric axes is known as isometric lines. Here, AB is parallel to x-axis, so it's an isometric line. Similarly, CD and EF both are isometric lines, and other lines are OP, LM. These are non-isometric lines. Why we are dealing with isometric and non-isometric lines? In isometric projection, the length of all isometric lines becomes 9 by 11 or 0.815 of its true length. But for non-isometric lines, there can be no one single fixed ratio. That is why for isometric projection, generally we use only the set of isometric lines. And for the conversion, the ratio we know, which is 9 by 11. For the conversion, we have these kind of graphical scales with us. Now I'll request you to please construct an isometric scale showing main divisions, subdivisions, true length, isometric length, angles, and main heading before examples. Thank you.